the fuck? These bitches start sending pictures of Nicole in the group chat. This time, sewings was real in. So she had a sewing and she had a bang. Bang chopped up. This shit low-key still scares me low-key. Bang chopped up. Like, her bang was like down here. Bang chopped up to like up here. Hair all disarray. Come in her hair from going to a party on campus, a college party on campus. Allegedly, she passed the fuck out. She don't know nothing that happened. She just woke up with cum in her hair, with her bang cut, her hair in disarray. The girl looked like she was dragged through the fucking grass. At this point, I'm just like, this stalker situation is getting way out of hand. I am low-key scared at this point. Why the hell we get a text message from our stalker, Simia? She gonna say, ha ha ha, bitch. That's why what happened to Nicole happened. I don't care about none of y'all bitches. I'ma see you when I see you. Don't let me catch you slipping. The bitch is literally ha ha laughing at this situation. Sending pictures in the group chat of Nicole. And the only person that we know that was with her is Fidelia and a whole bunch of niggas. That's when I put two and two together and I said, oh no. No, 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 no. Find me Fidelia, we all wanna fight now. My channel, and today we're going to be doing another installment of 12 days of story time. I really hope you guys are enjoying this. Today we are going to be talking about the time my stalker broke into my dorm room, stole my shit, stole my roommate's shit, and stole $200 from her. Before we get started, I have to give you guys a couple of disclaimers. One, this is probably gonna be one of the most unbelievable, ridiculous stories you probably ever heard on YouTube. So buckle up, get ready. Probably gonna be a long one, get your snacks. And most importantly, because I know a lot of you guys are probably gonna think this is fucking ridiculous and this is fucking crazy, I did go all the way back to Bloomfield to go and try to get the police report, but sadly, everything has been digitized ever since that whole situation happened. But they were able to give me proof that the report was indeed filed. So here it is, I will have it up on the screen. Now what's very funny is, if you guys check the date, you will see that the date that the whole situation happened with my shit getting stolen was actually on April 1st, 2014. And you guys are like, wait, April Fool's Day? Yeah. April Fool's Day. This was no fucking joke, okay? This was not a game. This was very, very serious. We had a stalker. They broke into our dorm room. They stole our shit. Nobody believed us. The school didn't believe us. Security didn't believe us. Even the cops were side-eyeing the hell out of us. But I guarantee you, this actually happened. And I'm still to this day very annoyed by it because this happened to me and my roommate. And both of us had absolutely nothing to do with the situation. We had absolutely nothing to do with this whole acts that this damn stalker had to grind with whoever, whenever, whatever. But some way, somehow, we got affected by this. There's a saying that goes, you know, you are your friends, and whatever your friends are, birds of a feather flock together. Absolutely untrue, because if that was the case, I'd be a criminal, I'd be a whore, probably be a prostitute. I literally have different types of friends or different types of acquaintances, whatever case you want to call it, from all types of places, all types of different walks of life. And I don't believe people's negative actions should affect you. I do believe this, and I believe the saying should be this: what your friends do will affect you. Okay, you may not be your friends, you may not be exactly who your friends are, you guys may not even have similar interests, but what your friends do will affect you. And this story is a prime example of that. If you do not take anything else from this story, you may not be who your friends are, but what they do may genuinely affect you. Because like I said, me and my roommate had absolutely nothing to do with this. Now what's funny is, I was actually thinking about this story not too long ago, and I was like, yo, I actually think it could have been anybody that was stalking us and taunting us and doing all of this goofy shit. Now, when I'm telling you this was a very, very scary situation, it was very, very scary. Like, anywhere we would go on campus, the person would literally put me and my friends in a group chat and start antagonizing us, okay? They were saying things like, you're a hoe, you're a bitch, you're a slut, fuck you, fuck this, fuck that. And what's crazy is, when they were calling someone out for being a hoe or being promiscuous or, you know, being a bad friend or whatever the case may be, everything that they would say was absolutely true, and it was very, very scary. If the person was sitting there just talking talking shit, we would have been like, all right, whatever, let it go, it doesn't matter. But this person was literally giving us legitimate shit that happened in our circle, legitimate information, legitimate everything. And you guys would probably be sitting there like, okay, it had to be one of you. To be honest, to this day, I feel like it had to be one of us, but it couldn't have been, because it literally would be all of us all together. And they would be like, I see y'all bitches in the cab, I see y'all bitches doing laundry, I see y'all bitches on the quad. So it's like, how the fuck, unless they were sitting here scheduling text messages, I have no idea. And I'm also one of those people, I'm very particular about who I give my number to. I do not just give my number to anyone. So it's like, whoever the fuck this was had to know us, because they had my goddamn number. So it was just a really, really crazy situation. And we definitely have to walk this all the way back for you guys to understand. Now, I actually did a roommates from hell college story time a while ago, and this story time actually should have came first before that. So if you guys did not watch that, you can definitely watch that after this, because it will make a lot more sense. I'm going to be jumbling up the names, probably going to be using the same names, because I really don't remember the names I used. So if I use the same name as, you know, something in the next story time, 9 times out of 10, it's probably not even going to be the same name. I'm telling you this right now, because I really don't remember the names I gave them in that story time, and I don't really care to go back and look for it. But like I said, we had a lot of enemies, and now that I think about it, there's reasons for it, but not really. Personally, I didn't have that many, but my squad did. Now, if you guys watched my previous vlogs way back in the day, some of them might be up, some of them might be, I actually might have to take them down before I put up this video, because I need to protect certain people's identities. But then again, you guys wouldn't really know who's who anyway. I had a college squad, okay? We used to call ourselves squad, okay? We had males, we had females, we had everybody in squad. We even had squad extended, okay? So if you had a bitch, you had a nigga, you had a side piece, you had a brother, a sister, whatever, and they could come hang out with us, we would call them squad extended. Like, squad was squad. Like, we was that shit, we was squad. Okay, we hung out a lot, okay? Some of us was commuters, some of us were residents, some of us was resumuters. If you guys do not know what a commuter is, someone who is a commuter in college is someone who goes to and from school in order to, you know, get their education. They do not stay on campus. A resumuter is someone that basically stays with someone that's a resident illegally, technically, and, you know, just doesn't pay shit and just reaps the benefits of living with, you know, a resident. So everybody was, you know, a mixed group. Different ethnicities, different nationalities, whatever the case may be, whatever you want to call it, but all different walks of life, all from different places, okay? Now, the thing is with squad is there was a lot of people in squad, better yet, a select few people in squad who had promiscuous behaviors that I believe led to this whole situation. I'm talking about catching certain things. I'm talking about sleeping with whoever and whatever, regardless of their status in terms of them being in a relationship or not. And they had that type of reputation, okay? Now, the thing is, I wouldn't know this, no one would know this, and most people wouldn't know this because this is me as a freshman, okay? This story takes place my freshman year of college. So understand what I may have done back then is not the shit that I would do now. Also understand, if you want to throw that shit in a circle, if you want to go sell drugs, whatever the case may be, that has nothing to do with me. But what your friends do will most likely affect you, okay? Please keep that in mind, because that's exactly what happened. And honestly, now that I look back at it, I probably wouldn't have it any other way, because I love my friends at the end of the day. I'm not beefing with nobody. I'm not coming for nobody. I'm not disrespecting anyone. I'm still cool with most of these people. There's no bad blood. I am still very annoyed, and I have every right to be very annoyed that my shit got broken into because of other people's actions, and I have every right to do that and to tell my story. However, understand, I'm very cutthroat. I'm very real about shit. I don't dance around things. I'm gonna say things the way it is. And sadly, a lot of the girls in squad in particular were very promiscuous, and they would do a lot of things that kind of fucked all of us over, including this situation right here. And then there were other situations and other friends that I had, you know, from squad extended that would also put us in very compromising positions. Now that I told you guys about squad, let's get into another situation that was going on with a girl in squad extended. We're gonna call this girl Danielle. Okay, now what's funny is I actually have another story time coming on Danielle, because Danielle had the nerve, all audacity to give me a motherfucking bald spot. Yes, I had a bald spot for a while when I first went natural, because, you know, she did my sew-in, and apparently I'm tender-headed, and I was complaining, but when I took out the fucking sew-in, I had a bald spot. So am I tender-headed, or bitch, do you braid too tight? Do you do hair too tight? Let me understand, let me know. But anyways, that's for another time. So me and Danielle, super cool, loved her to death. And we're just gonna have to give my roommate a name, because we have to be able to follow this. My roommate, we're gonna name her Michelle, okay? So funny enough, Michelle never liked Danielle. I have no idea why, but hey, whatever. I love Danielle, and that's all that matters. Danielle actually had a boyfriend. When I'm talking about boyfriend, I'm not talking about no little baby ass la la boyfriend that, you know, you guys get in high school and you think that you're in love with them and then you stay with them forever thinking that, you know, you're gonna go to college and, you know, live your life and have a million, no. This was a real boyfriend that she had from back home and they were together for years. And some way, somehow, don't ask me how, because I don't understand it, she was friends with, we're gonna call him Super Thot. Now you guys are like, Ivana, that's not me. First you said your friends were promiscuous, now you're calling this man Super Thot. Come on now. Let me just tell you this right now. Like I said, I'm a real bitch. Super Thot is a real nigga. He will say, I fucked this bitch, I fucked that bitch, and I got the videos to prove it. He was that type of nigga. I'm also pretty aggressive, so shit may just come off a way that you may not like, but it is what it is. Those girls were doing things that they know damn well they probably shouldn't have done, and it's crazy because a lot of these girls picked up this reputation literally like the first week of school. Doesn't mean I love them any less. Doesn't mean they're bad people. Doesn't mean that, you know, I was sitting here, you know, judging them the whole time, but I just have to tell it how it is, and that's the only way you guys are gonna understand what happened, because if I don't say that, you guys are gonna be very, very confused, okay? Literally, I have to give the entire scope of what's going on here, okay? So Super Thot was literally the type of dude that you never want to deal with, okay? He has videos of every girl that he's had sex with. Apparently, the pipe is really amazing, and girls just couldn't get enough of him, okay? And he had a girlfriend, not girlfriend, situation that we're gonna call Thing 2, because honestly, she's not even that fucking important, so we're just gonna call her Thing 2. And you guys are probably gonna be like, okay, so where is this going? So yes, Danielle was friends with Super Thot, very good friends, like best friends with Super Thot. Meanwhile, she had a boyfriend. I would never be friends with any guy that was a whore, okay? Literally a man whore, a self-proclaimed man whore, talking about, I got 66 bodies, I got 92 bodies. I kid you not, he literally kept count. I never heard of any type of shenanigans like this, but hey, that's you. The problem that occurred with Super Thot and Danielle's little friendship is it caused us so many fucking problems, okay? Now, Danielle wasn't squad, but she was like squad extended. She would be with us a lot, especially with me a lot. So when people saw me, they would see her or Michelle or the three of us, because at one point we were all cool, but then some way, somehow, Michelle and Danielle fell off. Well, Michelle just didn't like Danielle. I don't think Danielle really ever noticed it until I ended up telling her. But listen, so long story short, eventually it got to a point. What's funny is Super Thot was actually friends with all of the, like, I guess, cooler boys. Now you guys would think, okay, Ivana, this is college. I thought you said that this type of shit don't happen in college. But you go to a small college, it's still pretty clicky. And Bloomfield College is a small college. Now, Super Thot was friends with a dude that I had a crush on at the time. And a lot of my other friends kind of had crushes on dudes in his clique as well. And the crazy thing is, all of his friends were decent men. They were okay. Super Thot was just trash. You're not always your friends, okay? Like, it's just, it is what it is. You wanna be a hoe, you wanna be a drug dealer, you wanna be a prostitute, whatever the case may be, do that, all right? Because if that was the case, I'd probably be in jail right now, okay? Like, I grew up in the hood. I know all types of different fucking people. So basically, I had a crush on somebody in his group. A couple of my friends had a crush on people in their group. And sometimes we would hang out, we would intermingle. And Thing 2, who was actually, you know, the ex-girlfriend situationship of Super Thot, did not like this. And to make matters worse, Danielle lived right next to her RA, and we're gonna call her RA Thing 1. I don't like this bitch. She don't like me either. She might be watching this. I don't know. I don't care. But hi, bitch. Y'all gonna know why I don't like her real quick, okay? So what's crazy is Thing 1 was RA for Danielle, and she would always bring Super Thot into the room. Thing 1 and Thing 2 are pretty much best friends, like very, very close friends. And she clearly did not like us because Thing 2 didn't like us either. So we're hanging out with your best friend's ex-man situationship, whatever the case may be, and we are all the upperclassmen around us. Like, I'll tell you this right now. I feel like that's why everybody was salty. Like, we're freshmen, we hanging out with all the juniors, all the seniors, we getting all the liquor, we getting into all the parties for free. Like, we was living la vida loca, okay, bitch? Like, we had it made. And I ain't gonna lie, niggas really, like, these girls, they really did not like us for that. And I really think that also could have been the catalyst for what happened. And the thing is, when it came to Thing 1, I really thought that me thinking that she didn't like me was just a personal thing. Like, I thought it was just me in my head. I was like, you know what, Thing 1 don't got a problem with me. There's no reason for her to have a problem with me. What the fuck I ever do to her? She not even my RA. I live upstairs, she live down here. Like, what the fuck is the problem? Bitch, let me tell y'all. So one day we decided we wanted to have a get together with all the boys, okay? Super Thot and his crew. Now the thing is, I don't know know what happened, but Danielle was like, you know what, I don't want to do it anymore. But mind you, she would always hang out with Super Thought and always have like the whole damn student center in her room anyway. So we decided, all right, we're not going to do it anymore. Now we have this other girl. We're going to have to call her Sumun. If you guys do not know what Sumun is because you're not Haitian, Sumun is someone that's all up in the sauce, okay? They're on people. That's literally the direct translation of Sumun. On people as fuck. That bitch is all up everywhere. She was one of those we like to call shook hot. She literally was very, very desperate for any male attention, any type of attention she could get, really. And when she found out we wanted to have this get together with all of the upperclassmen boys, she was on the shit. She's like, oh my God, I really can't wait. Like, oh my God, y'all can have it in my room. Oh my God, I could go get bottles. Da, da, da. I was like, bitch, why are you so hyped? Like, it was just weird. Like, even though we were hanging out with all the upperclassmen and shit, we weren't sitting here acting all ivy feast about it. Like, we weren't sitting there like, oh my God, like, we that shit, we hanging out. Like, we were definitely not like that. I promise you, that definitely was not like the vibe it was giving. But everybody else was giving the vibe that like we were somewhat cool because we was hanging out with upperclassmen. Like, it's not that hard, just go fucking talk to them. I don't know. So like, when she found out we were having this whole situation, she really was like, oh my God, like, I really want to come, blah blah blah, what time? Like, she was really in it, and we were just like, yeah, we'll let you know, bitch. Like, you know, because at one point, like, because by the time like she kind of found out about it, we were just like, okay, we probably never gonna have it anymore, mainly because it was a little too hot, you feel me? Like, it was a little too like, like, your RA live right next door, and then I live right next to my RA as well. Like, she kind of lived like on the other side, and I lived on one side but upstairs. So we were like, yeah, if we do have to get together, it's gonna be risky because we're gonna get caught up. Bloomfield College is a dry campus. We're under the age of 21. We bring in bottles. We bring in a whole bunch of loud ass motherfucking niggas. Super Thought is dating Thing 2, which is also best friends with your RA, Thing 1. Like, it's gonna be messy. Let's not do it. So we told Sumun we're not doing it anymore. And then she's like, oh no, I'm gonna do it. I'll host it in my room. I have no problem. We could just bring it over there because she lived way further down the hall, like completely further. If you have a get together or some sort of turn up down the hall, you're not gonna hear it. So I was like, you know what? Whatever. We could do it over there. And then all of a sudden, like, literally hours before we were supposed to have it, sis backed out. So we like, all right, whatever, fuck it. I'm thinking I'm gonna have a chill night. I'm putting on my pajamas. I literally remember I had little slippers on. I had my booty shut, and I had my little tank top. I had my hair in a bonnet. I was chilling with Danielle, okay? We literally went upstairs to go get something. I'm not joking, y'all. We couldn't have been gone for more than 5 minutes. We come back downstairs, while the whole student center on her floor. What's good? Where the party at? Where we at? Yo, shorty, what's up? Hey, yo, Danielle, what's good, y'all? Yo, waterfall, water. I don't think I've been shocked that bad in my life. I was just like, oh my God. I'm so happy this is not my floor because y'all about to get a fine. Like, I was like, oh no. Yo, what I'm telling y'all, these dudes, and they running up and down. Like, I guess they already drank. They already pregame, girl. They is running up and down the halls. They yelling, they screaming. They have no fucks, no regard for where they at. We are in a freshman dorm. We are on a dry campus. Do you have no respect for us? We're just like, oh my God, we have to bring all of these boys into one corner somewhere. Like, one somewhere, because we're gonna be in some shit. Like, do you not understand? We're gonna be in some shit. What do? We just throw them in Sumun's room. And now that's when Sumun says, yeah, you know I said I wasn't gonna do it, and I know you guys said you didn't want to do it, so I decided to have it anyway. This is your fault, bitch. That's why you were so damn happy to have them in your room. Listen, you copped that fine. I had nothing to do with this shit. But I was like, you know what, this shit is not even gonna last more than 30 minutes because this is the whole student center is in the motherfucking dorm. And I was right. Within 30 minutes, my ass didn't even get a little lick. I didn't get the Hennessy. I didn't get shit. I can get it now though. All right, coming to the door. Y'all all gotta get out. This is Thing 1. Y'all gotta get out. You don't live here. You don't live here. You don't live here. None of y'all fucking live here. Get the fuck out. Cursing us out. If you don't live in this room, get out. You don't live on this floor, get out. Da 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 da. Like, yo, she's going in. And I'm just sitting there like, who the fuck? Like, I go about my merry business because this had nothing to do with me. It's not even on my floor. Why the fuck my RA wake me up the next day in the morning talking about some, what was y'all doing yesterday? I said, nothing. And mind you, I was very cool with my RA. Like, I loved her. She knew we was turning up and she never bothered us. I swear to you, REH always put me next to the RAs because they knew we was going to turn up. And I feel like they was always trying to catch us doing some goofy shit. And I actually did get caught, but I never paid that fine. And it was never added to my tuition. So, ha, jokes on y'all. Fuck y'all, Bloomfield. But anyways, what's funny is she was like, yeah, you know, the RA downstairs, like, you know, Thing 1, she was asking me for your information because she wanted you to get a fine for whatever the fuck was going on with Danielle and Sumun yesterday. Who? Me? She wanna get me a fine? Okay, so so basically, you hate me. That's basically what I was like, all right, so clearly that girl don't like me. And I didn't even do that. And I'm like, yo, I didn't take your nigga. I didn't take your daddy. I didn't do shit to you. What this got to do with me? You got your two people, okay? This bitch had it. I don't even know why Danielle got in trouble for that, because Suma was the one that wanted to have it. Suma was the one that did have it. Suma was the one that got caught red-handed with all the liquor and all the dudes in her room. I have no idea why Danielle got caught up for that. I have no idea why she's trying to catch me up for that. She would have caught these cans, because back then, I was still about that shit. Okay, this is 2014 Ivana. 2014 Ivana was about to go downstairs. I kid you not, I was like, oh, really? And my room, my RA was like, Ivana. I was like, no, let me. She was like, Ivana. I said, why? Like, all right, clearly this bitch don't like me. Honestly, later on that year, she started a rumor that I fucked some upperclassman that I did have a crush on. Funny enough, we were very, very cool, but I never fucked that man. I was never on that promiscuous shit. Shit, low-key, I regret not doing some things to some people, but I didn't do shit, mainly because of the STD rate, and also because I was usually talking in and out with very serious people at the time. So it was just like, bro, I ended up in a whole committed relationship by the end of my freshman year into, like, my junior year. So I was like, all right, clearly this girl don't like me, and I'm sure she doesn't like me because of Thing 2 and Thing 2's relationship with Super Thought and Super Thought's relationship with Squad and everybody else, because there would be times we all hung out. So now you guys are getting a synopsis. I have a squad of girls and boys, and a lot of the girls are known to sleep with men who are in relationships and do all types of other crazy shit. I have another friend that's hanging out with the biggest whore in the school that every girl for whatever reason wants, and since I'm associated with her, people are kind of associating that with me, and since everybody want to fuck him or whatever the case may be, and he's giving these girls false promises, they looking at us thinking that we hindering him from doing this, that, and the third. I don't even understand how that makes sense, but that's what happened. Now we have my final theory and my final culprit. My final theory and my final culprit would be my roommate Michelle's ex-roommate. Now we gotta give more names. So back in the day when I first got to Bloomfield College, my first roommate, her name was Ashley. And Michelle's first roommate, we're gonna call her Aggie, because this bitch was fucking Aggie as fuck. I see her now, she's grown so much and she's not like this anymore, but that bitch was Aggie as fuck. That was my original squad. My original squad was literally a 2 week old squad, okay? We didn't last. And that is because one day Aggie woke up and she said, I don't wanna be roommates with Michelle no more. Michelle is trying to take my man. Michelle is taking my food. All used to hang out together, and it was like maybe like six of us. It was a small group of us. And mostly everyone was like from like down South Jersey. Me and Michelle were the only ones that were up from North Jersey. I'm telling you right now, this girl, it was like night and day. She literally woke up one day and just decided she's gonna beef with Michelle. And I'm sure she told Ashley what the real reason was, because her and Ashley knew each other from back in South Jersey. And you know, they were way closer. So I don't know, like literally all of a sudden, it just became me and Michelle. So me and Ashley are fine. They were having such horrible issues that they asked for a roommate change. And basically it was going to be Ashley and Aggie becoming roommates, and me and Michelle becoming roommates, which is how it, you know, ended up going. And the funny thing about it is, she at one point wanted me to move out and move to, you know, her and Michelle's room. And Michelle and Aggie's room was the most horribly placed room. It was literally like in front of the bathroom. Bitch, I am not about to be placed in front of the bathroom. People be getting drunk. People be fucking. You want to move, you got the problem. You're beefing with Michelle, okay? You're beefing with Michelle, Aggie. You're the one being Aggie. You bring your Aggie ass right over there, okay? I'm not moving. We still to this day don't know what happened. Her and that nigga didn't even work out. And I genuinely feel like this is one of those scenarios where the girl was just jealous. Now, when it came to Michelle, Michelle was a beautiful girl with a fat ass. And, you know, I feel like every time he would bring her, every time she would bring him in there, maybe he was side-eyeing, looking at her, whatever. Because she had a lot of those dudes in that specific clique always trying to talk to her, get with her, and all types of goofy shit. I kid you not, I couldn't stand the fact that they put a damn microwave all the way downstairs on the boys' floor. We couldn't even go downstairs to make ramen noodles without these niggas bothering us and fucking harassing us. I mean, the dude was all up on Michelle, and Michelle never cared for him, never gave him the time of day, even after they stopped fucking with each other. So it was like, bruh, nobody wanted your nigga. Like, so after that situation, and now that I think about it and I look at it, yeah, we had a lot of people that could have been our motherfucking stalkers, okay? A lot of people that probably really didn't like us because they thought that we was fucking they niggas, talking to they niggas, wanting they niggas. And it's like, all of these niggas are trash. I don't care that niggas don't like us, niggas wanna fight us, like, but honestly, bitches really could've caught these hands, because I was very, very annoyed, and it was just so problematic. Niggas was side-eyeing us all the time, or whatever, but, like, it was kinda like a subtle side-eye, and it was also, like, a fake thing. It would be like, oh my god, hey, hi, and it'd be like, mm. But you know that type of shit, where people, like, they like you, but they don't like you, but they're not gonna tell you that they don't like you, so it's just gonna be a fake bitch. None of us cared, because we had each other, we had squad, like, it was even to the point where any dude that was dating any boy in squad, whether it was in the school or not, they would be sitting like, oh my god, you're friends with that, da, da, da. Like, now, like I said, it didn't help the big titties, the big butt, and the fact that I was always dressed to the nines. I'm still always dressed to the nines. If you guys are not aware, I wear heels all the time. I'm always dressed up. I never wore makeup like that ever, but I always wore like little lipstick and stuff. Like, I was very, very dressed, like, all the time. So yeah, we were some baddies, bitch. Okay, we were some baddies. And then the rest of the squad, they were some baddies too. I genuinely feel like it was jealousy, and then the fact that some people were doing things that they shouldn't have been doing, and the fact that we were getting a lot of the upperclassmen men's attention, that's what kind of fueled this. So one day, freshman year, we're all just sitting around, and we all get added to a group chat. Now, what's crazy about this is we were just like thinking it was a joke, and I guess when we kind of ignored it, everything just got 10 times worse. Now this person's like, hey bitches, it's me, it's Simia. Yes, this was the name that the stalker chose. So we're all just sitting around like, who the fuck is Simia? Did I get a text from a bitch named Simia? And we're like, yeah, I got it too. And we're just like, what in the Pretty Little Liars is going on here? I'm not gonna answer, because bitch, you're not gonna call me a bitch. I don't know who the fuck you are. Two, I feel like someone's trying to gaslight us. Guys, just ignore it. I'm telling everybody to ignore it. They're not ignoring it. Bro, they start going back and forth with the goddamn shadow. Listen, even on YouTube, if you do not show your face, I'm not going back and forth with you. And I'm watching my friends literally go back and forth on the phone. I'm watching this shit on my phone. All I see is the whole squad secrets getting leaked. Well, this person fucked this person. This person got an STD. This person got pregnant and got an abortion. This person, da 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 da. And I'm just sitting here looking at the group chat like, who is this? Every single thing that this person was saying was accurate. Even now, I'm very particular about who I give my number to. So I knew. I was like, all right, so one of y'all is joking. At this point, we started looking at each other like, everybody's like, nah, it ain't me. How they know all our business? Because there was nothing in there about me and Michelle whatsoever, because there was nothing they can say. We was not out here fucking and sucking everybody. So we were just sitting here like, no, this person has to be one of us, or has to be someone that we hang out with actively, because they have my number. I do not give my number out to everyone. Whoever the fuck Simia was literally killing squad with the secrets. It was a lot of us in squad, okay, between girls and guys, whatever. All of us had like our own little extended groups. How is this even possible when literally all of us are in the same room? So it can't be one of us unless the person is scheduling shit. Another theory that I had was that this person could have been another crew that we had. Funny enough, we had some short-lived crews before we had the long-lived crew, okay? Now, this is actually gonna go into another story that I'm gonna tell during this series about one of my friends getting alcohol poisoning, because that was a lot. I'm probably gonna look bad in some of these stories, but it is what it is. You guys gotta learn the lessons that I learned the hard way. But in particular, there was a whole situation where me, Michelle, and there was another girl we're gonna call Ashton, okay? Me, Michelle, and Ashton, we were cool with, you know, about four other people. So it used to be like the six, maybe seven of us, because someone else went off to the military. It was about seven of us. We were really cool clique, and shit fell apart because I started beefing with one of the girls, and then Michelle started beefing with one of the girls, and I believe Ashton was roommates with one of the girls. She got alcohol poisoning. The girl ended up calling the RA. The ambulance came. Like, it was a whole big situation. And part of me still probably might think maybe one of them had something to do with this, because ever since that whole breakup, like, those girls never fucked with us. They was always talking shit about us anytime we would hear about it. Just another group of bitches that genuinely didn't like us for absolutely no reason, because honestly, I didn't do nothing to these hoes. These hoes don't know our squad's business. Like, they don't know what we know about our friends. They don't know anything like that. We don't talk to them. Who the fuck is telling them their business? So we kind of ruled them out, because this person was literally being like the Pandora box of all secrets. Like, it was to the point where we low-key got scared, and we never walked around with like less than four people. And how the fuck they were able to like know everyone's business, but on top of that, know where we are at all given times. We're in the calf. I see y'all bitches in the calf. We doing laundry, which is in the basement. And there's literally maybe one little ass window that looks into the laundry room. Oh, I see see y'all bitches doing laundry. I'm in the library. Ooh, I see shorty bitch ass in the library. Oh, I'm in class. Oh, yo, bitch ass in class. You better learn now because you're gonna learn today. Like, it was bad. And we're just like, how? How's this person everywhere and we don't see anything? At this point, we started thinking it was a network of bitches. Like, maybe everybody that just didn't like us kind of just teamed up. At this point, we don't know what to do because, like, we're literally being harassed. It even got to the point where people didn't even want to hang out with us, y'all. Like, people were scared to hang out with us because, like, oh my god, they got a stalker. Oh, they got a stalker. Oh no, don't hang out with them, they got a stalker. Like, it was really bad, y'all. Like, it was a whole fucking situation. Like, people were really, like, afraid. Anytime somebody did hang out with us, like, say it was like squad extended, they would get a text message. Everybody was just becoming very, very paranoid. So of course we would sit here, we would block the numbers. The person would make a whole new number. It's me, bitches. It's Simia, bitches. It's me, hoes. Y'all can't get rid of me, bitches. Da 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 da. And we just like, bro. Eventually we just let it fly. We was like, you know what? We just gonna let the person talk, blah blah blah. And eventually my friends kind of stopped cursing out the person because they realized that wasn't doing anything. It was probably making everything worse. And then that's when we had this whole situation with a girl in squad. And this is when I was just like, you guys are so fucking ridiculous. This is when shit really got serious. And we were just like, okay, we have to figure out who this was. Now when it came to Simia would have these periods of times where she would just leave us alone, okay? She wouldn't hit us up. She would come out the word works after a couple weeks, maybe a month or two, and you know, she would harass us again, right? This time, it was actually pretty creepy. This whole situation, I was very shocked by it. I used to work at the doctor's office, Haitian doctor's office, from Friday to Saturday. So I would leave campus around maybe like 1 o'clock, get there around 4 o'clock, whatever the case may be. And what's crazy about this is we always told ourselves when it came to campus, we would never be around by ourselves because we wanted to know who it was, wanted to make sure nothing would happen because this person was literally threatening us, okay? They were threatening to hurt us, threatening to beat us up, threatening to kill us at one point. Like, we had so many types of death threats. Now, what really makes me mad about this whole story, I have no fucking screenshots. That is why I went to go get the police report receipt situation because this situation, this story sounds fucking outrageous and I'm the screenshot queen. Like I said, I would go to work, right? I would go to work from Friday. I would come back on campus Sunday, sometimes Monday morning. Now, I said we all vowed that we are not gonna walk around by ourselves. We also decided we're not going to go to any turnips on campus because clearly someone don't fucking like us. What the fuck did these dumb ass bitches do? We had one dumb bitch. We're gonna call her Nicole. Nicole took it upon herself to go to a turn up with a squad extended. We're gonna call her Fidelia. So Fidelia and Nicole went to a party. Now the thing is with Fidelia, I never trust that bitch. I never liked that bitch. And that was the person that we thought was Simia from day one because she was the only person that would hang out with squad extended and squad like in the girl side. So the girls lived in Schweitzer Hall. Okay, me and Michelle and some boys, maybe like two or three of the boys actually lived in Clee, but everybody else lived in Schweitzer, which was another freshman dorm in Bloomfield. She was constantly with them, but she was also constantly having issues to the point where one girl in my crew actually drop kicked that bitch. And when it came to Fidelia, Fidelia was a big bitch. She got into a whole fight with Fidelia. She drop kicked her at the party, basically knocked her the fuck out. And literally from then on, it ruined her damn street cred on campus and people was laughing at her like, ha, you got drop kicked by a little ass bitch. Now people need to understand, just cause someone's smaller don't mean they can't fight because clearly that proved it, okay? She got her ass beat and I feel like she was definitely butthurt by it. And I don't even remember what they was fighting over. I feel like it could have been some alcohol shit, but whatever it was, they actually ended up mending their relationship and all of them ended up being cool again and hanging out again. She was about a junior at the time that we were freshmen and they were always with her. I never trust that bitch. I kid you not. As soon as I'm here, I was like, don't like her, don't care for her. I would hang with her when they, you know, when she was around, I would say hi to the girl, but I was never all up in her in the sauce, tell her my business, none of that goofy shit because just something about her was not genuine to me. We telling Fidelia about this, she don't seem fazed. Okay, she don't seem fazed. She's, I don't know, something about it just always seemed weird to me. And we always thought it was her. We like, it has to be her because we're just like, how the fuck is this person knowing all this information? So Nicole decided to go to a party with Fidelia and this shit ended up being really bad. Now the person that we suspect is our stalker is the person that you decide to go out with on weekend. You guys are not aware, Bloomfield College is a very dry, boring ass campus. If you're thinking of going there, don't fucking go there. Okay, there's no parties going on, there's no nothing going on unless the students throw it. Okay, we have to throw all the parties, we have to make all the fun on campus. There is no frat houses. My phone's blowing up, so something happened to Nicole, something happened to Nicole. I'm like, something shouldn't be happening to Nicole because all of us decided we're gonna do a buddy buddy system type situation when we go on campus, it gets real, real empty on weekends. Like, nobody stays for weekends. Everybody leaves. Everybody goes back home. Like, you go to Bloomfield College on a fucking weekend, it's ghost town. Like, nobody's there. We don't know where Nicole at. Nicole not answering the phone. And I'm just sitting there like, who sent Nicole? I'm kind of ignoring my phone, but I'm kind of like, you know, keeping up with the updates. You know how y'all see like a group chat and you just like kind of like scroll up, but then, you know, some people were texting me individually and they're like, bro, like some shit's going down. Like, I know something bad's happening. Like, Simi is out there. We don't know where the fuck Nicole at. I'm like, why the fuck these bitches start sending pictures of Nicole in the group chat? This time, sew-ins was real in. So she had a sew-in and she had a bang. Bang chopped up. This shit low-key still scares me low-key. Bang chopped up. Like, her bang was like down here. Bang chopped up to like up here. Hair all disarray. Come in her hair from going to a party on campus, a college party on campus. Allegedly, she passed the fuck out. She don't know nothing that happened. She just woke up with cum in her hair, with her bang cut, her hair in disarray. The girl looked like she was dragged through the fucking grass. At this point, I'm just like, this stalker situation is getting way out of hand. I am low-key scared at this point. Why the hell we get a text message from our stalker, Simia? She gonna say, ha ha ha, bitch. That's why what happened to Nicole happened. I don't care about none of y'all bitches. I'm gonna see you when I see you. Don't let me catch you slipping. The bitch is literally ha ha laughing at this situation. Sending pictures in the group chat of Nicole. And the only person that we know that was with her is Fidelia and a whole bunch of niggas. That's when I put two and two together and I said, oh no. No, 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 no. Find me Fidelia. We all want to fight now. Like, what part of we're supposed to all be at least with one another do you guys not understand unless we're leaving campus? Like, on campus, we all have to be with somebody because this shit cannot be happening. Now, of course, nobody reported any of this. You know why? Because black people, a lot of us don't like cops in our business. And honestly, we thought we could handle it ourselves. To be honest, if this was me right now, I don't give a fuck. I really would have told the police first day, first come, first like, first initial issue. She the one with cum in her hair with her hair chopped up, looking like she got dragged through the goddamn floor like a goddamn rag doll. Now, we don't see Nicole for a couple days because clearly that's a pretty traumatic experience. We didn't even know the story. We just knew she went out, she was with Fidelia, she was with the soccer boys, and that's how she came back. Now we finally talked to, you know, Nicole, and we talked to Fidelia. Fidelia, she ain't giving a shit, okay? Fidelia, I believe we talked to her and Nicole separately. Fidelia's also, oh my God, yeah, I don't know. We just went out to this party. All of a sudden, I saw her passed out, and I picked her up, and I brought her here. Well, aren't you a goddamn superwoman, superhero-ass bitch? That's convenient that you happen to be the only one with her in some way, somehow, you don't know anything that happened to her. Like, what kind of bullshit is this? But when we're talking to fucking Nicole, Nicole is sitting here and she's just like, well, yeah, like, I just don't remember anything. Like, I literally blacked out. Come to find, we find out Nicole is fucking Fidelia's little side nigga that she's fucking. So now I'm just sitting here like, now we have to give him a name because I feel like he's the one that gave access to my room, but more on that later. So we're gonna call this soccer player side piece of Fidelia. That nigga was ugly. So we gonna call him Ogre because that nigga, he was ugly. So now we have someone in the squad that whooped your ass and drop kicked you in front of everybody at a frat party. Yes, that was that frat party. I forgot to mention that. So clearly that's very embarrassing. And we have another person in the squad that's fucking your nigga. No wonder we have a fucking stalker. You really got us in some shit. Like, I'm like, y'all really got us in some shit right now. Like, I was really like looking at Michelle like, I know these are our friends, they really got us in some shit because we're literally going through this because they want to sit here and throw their ass in a circle. Like, this is fucking ridiculous right now. So now let's fast forward to April Fool's. Now you guys are probably going to think, oh, Ivana, maybe you left your door unlocked, maybe you left your key in the door, all this goofy shit. Let me just tell you right now, I'm a very, very responsible person, especially when it comes to locking up my shit. I grew up in the hood. I do not play that goofy shit. I lock doors. Michelle grew up in the hood. She locks doors, but she's also pretty lackadaisical. But even at that, I'm the type of person, since I know how kind of lackadaisical she could be, I would let her walk out first and I would go out with her. So even when we would be kicking it outside till 2 a.m., me and her were together. I know that door was locked. The only time we didn't lock that door was when we would go in the shower. Now, we had community showers, sadly, for freshman year. And that would probably be the only time we did not go and actually lock the door. We'd kind of like leave something in the door because it was easier. Like, nobody got time. Like, realistically, no one has time to be sitting here putting keys in the door and all of that when you're in the shower. Like, you kind of just want to come in and come out. And even at that, me and her took showers at the same time. Like, we were always in and out at the same time. So this day in particular, we go to class. 7:30 7:30. Oh, I remember like it was yesterday. Go to class 7:30. We hang out in the den. We come back to the room. Oh, the den is the student center, y'all. I'm chilling and it's April Fool's Day. Now, Michelle's sitting here looking for her shit. And I'm just sitting here looking at her, looking for her shit. Like, why is it taking you so long to find your shit? Like, what are you looking for? She's like, I'm looking for my laptop. And I'm like, oh. She's like, did you see it? I'm like, no. Check your desk. I don't see it. Come on, shorty. Stop playing. You take my laptop? Why would I take your laptop? Ivana, I know it's April Fool's. It's April Fool's, Ivana. Come on. Shorty, give me my laptop. I don't have your laptop. Like, I don't know what you're talking about. Yo, bruh. Shorty, you play too much, bruh. I'm like, do I fucking look like a bitch that like to play games? I do not have your laptop. So she's sitting there looking like, yo, I kid you not. At this point, it's been like 15 minutes. Time goes by. And I'm like, you know what? Let me try to find my laptop. Because I'm like, all right, I'll just give her my laptop to do work. Bro. Now I'm like, what the fuck? Where's my laptop? So we're just looking and looking and looking and looking and looking up, down, all around. We're like, oh shit. I'm like, don't tell me we just got robbed, bitch. Did we just get robbed? There's no way we just got robbed. Did we just get robbed? So we're just looking at each other and she's like, no, 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 no. Now the thing is, Michelle is a big ass crybaby. She's a big ass over exaggerator and she be doing the goddamn most. So she's about to chow. She's in tears. She is bawling. She's like, oh my God, what the fuck? What the fuck? And mind you, her laptop was a lot better than mine. Like, she had one of those, like, HP, was it? Or Dell. It was one of those laptops where it was, like, kind of, like, touchscreen and it flipped and all that goofy shit. It was a really nice laptop. And it was a gift. So, she is sick. Okay, she is just like, oh my God, like, what the fuck? Like, there's no way. Like, shorty, stop playing. Like, please tell me this is not a joke. I'm like, I can't find my laptop either, Michelle. This is not a joke. I can't believe this. Now she starts going through her money. Like, she had her money in a specific place. This is how I know whoever did this knew us, because she never really put her money in her wallet. She put it like in a specific place. I don't remember where it was, but it was very specific. And the only people that would know that would be me or someone else in Schwab. Bitch. Now she see all her money gone. About like $200 worth. Gone. Zenny, done. Bye. Bum, bum, beat him. Bye, bitch. Oh my God. Oh, the waterworks. Oh my God. Shorty, we got robbed. What the fuck? I can't believe this shit. Nah, these bitches making my shit. Who the fuck? All of a sudden, we get a text from our stalker. Ha ha, bitches. I got your shit. At this point, I'm like, this is out of fucking control. This is out of fucking control. Yo, nah, bro. At this point, now I'm mad. Cause I'm like, oh, she better hope. She better hope. Cause now you taunting us. So was a ha ha ha, I got your shit. And like, she like the whole day she taunted us. How's your laptop? Ha ha, did you find your laptops yet? Ha ha ha, that's what the fuck y'all bitches get. Da 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 da, I told you I wasn't fucking with y'all. I ain't play with y'all. I'm gonna come after all y'all bitches. Da da. And I'm just like, what the fuck did we do? What the, me and her were never mentioned in these texts. So now we go and we get our RA and we're like, yo, someone stole our laptops and stole Michelle's money. And I believe they broke into here. All right. It's April Fool's. I'll believe you tomorrow. We're like, no, girl, no. Like, someone really stole our shit. Like, someone broke into here. On April Fool's Day. Yes, someone broke into our room on April Fool's Day. Literally. Probably a couple hours ago. I don't know. But I really feel like whoever it was definitely had a key or something, because we do not leave our door open whatsoever. So, like, I don't know what's going on here. This is actually very creepy, and we believe it's, like, our stalker that we've had. Now she's really looking at us like we're crazy. Uh-huh. If this is really serious, I'm gonna go call security. And she turns around to go call security, and then she looks back at us like we about to fucking, like, recant the story. She's like, oh, y'all dead ass? Like, this is not an April Fool's joke? We're like, this is not a game. Our shit just got stolen. Like, girl. Our shit is, yo, I'm just like, this is a joke. This is a joke. There's no reason for this to be this fucking ridiculous right now. She's like, oh, okay, all right. I believe you guys now. I believe you guys now. Because at this point, now Michelle is chow, like her face is red, her eyes are red. She's screaming, she's yelling, she's punching brick walls because literally these damn dorm rooms was like jail cells. She's going off, okay? And I'm just like, does she look like she's joking? Do we look like we would really do all of this for a fucking April Fool's joke? This is not a game. After literally probably 30 to 40 minutes of convincing her that the story was real, she finally called security. So now security comes and we go through the whole thing all over again. Mm-hmm. On April Fool's Day. You guys had a stalker? Why didn't you say something before? Why ain't nobody say anything about this? Why didn't you report this to the police? You guys are comfortable just walking around campus knowing that someone is threatening you guys? All these fucking questions. Like, listen, can you just tell us what to do about our shit being stolen and someone breaking into here? Because now we don't feel safe. So now it was this whole thing. They had to change the locks. We had to get new keys. And I was just like, I really think that it had to be an RA, because how the fuck did that person get in here? And then it started clicking. I was like, RA, that's funny. Ogre's an RA. Ogre's fucking Fidelia. Fidelia low-key doesn't like people in squad, and I feel like she's only doing it because she has an ulterior motive. There's no way. It all started to click, because I'm like, that's the only person. That's the only thing that makes sense. I feel like he helped her get into the goddamn room to take our shit. It could be the collection of other bitches that don't like us because of fucking niggas at this point. Because at this point, everybody's a bitter-ass bitch for niggas that they didn't even fucking marry. I started getting annoyed. The funny thing is, I was very calm about this. Like, from the security to the RA, and then the police come, I'm very calm about this. The police are really looking at us like, so run this back again. You guys had a stalker for months and no one reported this, because we're like, listen, people literally stop hanging out with us because of this stalker. I don't think you understand how ridiculous this story sounds, but clearly you do, because you're looking at us like we're fucking crazy because it's on April Fool's Day and someone broke into our dorm room. This is not a game. This is not a joke. Someone came into our shit. And what makes all of this worse is there was no cameras, okay? No cameras in Klee Hall. And I don't believe there was any in Schweitzer at the time either. And I don't know if now they have cameras, but they fucking should, because that would have definitely told us what the fuck was going on and who the fuck would have took our shit. But sadly, there was no goddamn cameras on the damn floor, so there was nothing anyone can really do except make a report. So now we finally make the report, and luckily we were covered by, you know, campus insurance that allegedly we paid for when we were living on campus. I think everyone had to do that. And basically, if something gets stolen, whatever, you can file for it, get the money reimbursement so that you can buy another one. The sad part is you had to prove that you owned it, so you have to have your receipt and stuff that you purchased something. So understand, guys, this was something you should always do. If you're going to have any type of electronic device, especially if you're gonna move on campus, stuff like that, always keep the receipt, because if something like this happens to you, more than likely you'll probably be able to get reimbursed from the school or whatever insurance plan that they have. And that's what happened to us. I got a MacBook after that, and she got the same laptop after that, but it was crazy because she had to go get the receipt from her sister, and her sister had to send it over. And it's crazy because, like I said, it was a gift. So luckily she was able to actually get the receipt and get a new, you know, laptop. I ended up getting a MacBook. Like, I was like, you know what, I need a new laptop anyway, like, I'm not fazed. But I was very mad that someone came into our space and took our fucking shit. But after that, I think a lot of people took the whole situation more seriously. They were just like, yeah, no, that's crazy, like, I'm sorry about what happened, blah blah blah. And I was like, you know what, fuck all y'all, I could be all y'all for all we care. So at that point, I became very, very, like, suspicious of everyone. I didn't trust nobody. So even after that, we'll continue to get text messages. Even the year after that and the year after that, okay, sophomore year we got messages, junior year we got messages, and I believe junior year is when we're finally like, we're not answering this shit, we don't give a fuck. Like, so that's when we finally were like, yeah, no more send me a bitch, you want to text us, you can text us all you want, but you're not gonna get a response. And that's that on that. And you know, we blocked the last number that she contacted us on. And you guys are probably wondering what happened to Fidelia. Fidelia actually got pregnant and never came back to the school, and to this day I still think it's her. As far as those other girls that didn't like us, like my ex roommate or whatever and Michelle's ex roommate, they didn't even fucking graduate. They ended up leaving school, getting, one of them ended up getting knocked up, the other one, I don't know what she doing, but I know she didn't finish school and she ended up dropping out. And then when it comes to squad, most of squad graduated, but a lot of squad didn't. And when it comes to a lot of the other girls that just didn't like us because of Super Thought, a lot of them ended up moving on, and now we're all cool anyhow for the most part. But it's just crazy to think, like, damn, there was a lot of people that didn't like us that really probably sat here, stole our shit, put cum in our friend's hair, and did all of this goofy taunting, harassment and shit all over niggas, okay? And it had to be over niggas because ain't nothing else, unless it's gonna be jealousy. But I find it really hard that anyone could be that jealous of a bunch of pretty bitches in a group that have a lot of guy friends, that they would do all of that. So I really feel like it had to be someone sleeping with someone's boyfriend, doing this, that, and the third, with this, that, and the third, that made this whole thing a problem. It is what it is. Make sure you guys comment down below, have you ever had a stalker situation? Have you ever had someone break into your house? You ever been robbed? Because that is a very horrible feeling. If you've ever got something taken away from you, especially in your home, you will know how, like, sacred and how close that hits to home, because that's somewhere you sleep, that's somewhere you live, you know, even if it's a dorm, because that's somewhere that you're temporarily living. That is like the biggest invasion of privacy. And honestly, we were low-key scared after that, because we're just like, what the fuck, like how in the world can someone do something like that to us? Like, you don't even do nothing to nobody. Like, yeah, we have friends that a lot of people don't like, but what the fuck that I do with us? So again, like I said, you may not be your friends, but what your friends do may affect you, and you have to be very, very careful who you are friends with, because you never know what the fuck they're doing, what they're not doing, whatever the case may be, that may make other people hate you or target you in order to get to them. So with that being said, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, and do all that, and I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye.